happy to have you with us for another state high school football championship game right here on HSE. Last week, the Division I title game saw Converse Johnson defend its title by defeating Plano. Now, those two schools were veteran playoff teams, accustomed to playing.
David Patterson back deep, and we are underway from the Astrodome in Houston. It's David Patterson from the 5-yard line. Patterson finds a crease and gets out over the 25-yard line, out to the 28, and that is where the Generals of Macarthur will start first down and 10.
Zeb Cornist with a shoestring tackle, one of the starters coming down on that kickoff coverage for Lewisville.
David Patterson, only a sophomore. He will have a lot to say about this, how this offense works today, and so will that man right there, Odell James, another sophomore. Rushed for over 1,400 yards and thrown for over 1,100 yards. First down and 10, the first play of the game. Quarterback draw, closed up nicely. The interior line, Merritt and Collinsworth, the first guys to get there. Also, Bonenberger, the nose tackle. Let's set the offense. The backs and receivers, the wide back, Raymond Robinson, they will really throw to him a lot. Roberts Patterson, that's Tatish Hodge, the fullback, and Delbert Garner, the all-everything tailback. Offensive line, they are big. It's Venegas, Babcock, Sosa, the anchor in the middle, and then Gonzalez and Brock, the left side of that line, particularly big. Venegas at 265 and Babcock at 245. They'll throw on second down, incomplete. Intended for Johnny Roberts, but he was separated from the football by Blaine Harrington. On the defensive side, the front seven, really the strength of this Fighting Farmer defensive line. Cornist and Branch, the ends. Merritt and Collinsworth, and then Bonenberger, the nose guard in the middle. The backers, that's Brazil and Welton. Brazil, he's as good as they get. He is only a sophomore. Defensive backs, Cotton and Frazier on the corners. Blaine Harrington with that big hit. Free safety, the right hunter. Sprint draw, Garner. Near the 40-yard line, will probably be short of a first down. He got very close on third down. John Carroll made the hit.
MacArthur starting here with looking as if they want to set up the pass and set up the pass with for the draw. Odell James going back the first play with a quarterback draw and then throwing a pass, and that time going with a draw again.
There's Bob Alpert in his 11th season at MacArthur. 96 wins, 32 down, and two ties. The eighth playoff appearance for the MacArthur Generals.
Boy, early to go for it in the ballgame on fourth and one deep in your own territory, but here they are.
Fourth down and a foot.
So the first big decision of the game by Coach Alpert is to go for it on fourth and one inside their own 40 for MacArthur. Lewisville up to the task. They stop MacArthur short of the first down. We'll see it here.
Watch Dan Merritt.
Great penetration.
Number 61 shot through there. That is his 16th tackle of the season for a loss. He leads the Fighting Farmer defense.
So Lewisville will start now in great field position at the 38-yard line in MacArthur territory.
And there's Chad Nelson on first down. They hand it off. Brazil, and Brazil just back to the line of scrimmage. So these two high-powered offenses have been kept in check so far. Anthony Williams made the hit. The backs and receivers this way. Newsom the split end. Holland is one back. He's the H-back. And then Mitchell the other H-back. Brazil the fullback. And Martin Simmons, when they throw it, they'll throw it to the tight end Simmons. Offensive line, these guys are big as well. Zealot and Anderson are the tackles. Phillips and Clark the guards. And Brett Johnson, the guy in the middle. Second down, 11. Brazil loses one on first down. Option, Nelson. Nelson cuts it up. Nelson will score. For Chad Nelson, and with 4.5 speed, once he turned the corner, nobody was going to catch him.
What a great job by the offensive line and the tight ends for Lewisville. Once Nelson got outside of the containment, he was gone. There was nobody close to him. He outran everybody. That's a try for point.
Topher, we got a dose of just how difficult it is to stop the triple option.
On the second play from scrimmage, they break the bone, does Lewisville, and they'll have a trailing back. But watch Chad Nelson as he will start outside. And the beauty of the option is to make cornerbacks make a decision one way or the other. And then you'll see it here. Chad Nelson will run the option. And watch the cornerback, Stephen Glenn. He can't make a decision on whether or not to go for Chad Nelson or whether to go for the pitch man. He's out off balance. Nelson goes right by him, outruns everybody, and it's a touchdown for Lewisville.
A fair catch is taken on the kickoff. Bruce Young made the fair catch for Macarthur. That's a heads-up play for a high school player to call that fair catch. You know you're not back there to run it back. It was a short kick, and Bruce Young did just that. So now Odell James, although he sees his team down 7-0, his ball club has been there before. This Macarthur team, this was a team that they weren't sure if they were going to make the playoffs. They had lost 3 consecutive district games during the season.
Well, and they got one through a forfeit to Aldine that they lost 18-17, and that's what got them in the playoffs. But here they are in the championship game.
Spring draw again, Delbert Garner. Garner bounces off the line of scrimmage, and that's it. A swarming defense for Lewisville. Reggie Crawford led the way. He came up from the strong safety position to make the play at the line of scrimmage. That'll tell you right there that Lewisville is daring Macarthur to throw the football. That last scoring drive for the Lewisville Fighting Farmers, it didn't take long. A 39-yard touchdown run by Chad Nelson. Now second down and 9. The Macarthur Generals trying to get something going with 9 minutes to go in the first quarter. Odell James on the option. James maybe a couple. Going is tough again. Again, we'll call the number 9, Reggie Crawford. Also Zach Weldon.
This is the counter option. Odell James moves to his left, reverses his field, and comes back, but it didn't fool Lewisville at all. They have got great speed and quickness on this defense, and they have not been fooled at all by the option attack from Macarthur.
Well, a third down and 11 coming up for the Macarthur Generals. One thing about the defense is the fact that every week or every day they see an option offense. Looking to throw. James will cut it up, knocked out of bounds, and Macarthur will have to punt.
This time Macarthur goes to a slot formation to the left, and they roll James out behind that slot. He couldn't find anybody open. Lewisville downfield with great coverage. He had to eat the football, and it's 4th and 10. And so far, Lewisville is controlling this football game.
So the White Hunter will go deep. Jeremy Lorette will kick it away. Lorette, a 34-yard average. Lewisville plays the return. Dwight Hunter. Hunter at midfield. And now Lewisville, in a game of field position, has owned this ball game.
Hunter showing great courage there. He caught that ball just before he was hammered. He bounced off a one tackle, but Macarthur had good coverage following that initial tackler.
Lewisville has outscored their opponents in the playoffs now 210-74. We're going to just go down with a Gatorade sideline report. Here's Craig Way. Craig?
Well, Kevin, the last time the Farmers had the football, as we all saw, it only took them 2 plays to score. After that touchdown, the defensive coaches for Macarthur went over, sat down with their kids and said, hey, somebody's hurt, got a long football game to go, relax, make your right reads, don't panic right now. Still a long way to go, Kevin.
You're right about that, especially with the big play offense of Macarthur. Chad Nelson under center. The 2 Lewisville drives have started inside Macarthur territory. Brazil in the middle. Maybe a couple. Anthony Williams, the first man to get to him.
He may have gotten a couple, but he got those couple on his own. He was hit right at the line of scrimmage and bounced off of people. We talked about his size at 220 pounds, 5'11". He picked up 2 on his own, and it'll be a 2nd and 8 for Lewisville.
Lewisville at 14-0-1. Macarthur at 12-3. 5 5A Division II state championship from the Astrodome. 8 minutes to go in the first quarter. Lewisville leading 7-0. They'll throw it. Incomplete. In and out of the hands of Martin Simmons. A big hit, though, by Charlie Foster, the 6'185" senior.
Interesting formation for Lewisville. They'll double break the bone. They put a wingman and then go motion with another man, and the ball is right in Simmons' hands, but he's unable to hold on to it. Got a big hit right as the ball got there.
And Charlie Foster did a good job separating flesh from football that time. Now a third down and 8. Lewisville from the Macarthur 48-yard line. The middle, Brazil well short of the first down, inside the 45 to the 44. Shadrick George, the 220-pound senior, made the hit for Macarthur.
You know what's interesting about Louisville and Lewisville and their wishbone attack? They give you so many different looks out of the wishbone. That time they split both tight ends out. They had two men in the slots and only one running back in the backfield, that being Brazil. And of course, they gave the ball to him, but they also can throw out of it. So a lot of misdirection in this wishbone attack.
So now a fourth down and 4. Topher Roach is in to punt it away for Lewisville. Only 2 on the play clock, and Lewisville wisely will call a timeout. I don't know why.
Well, that's wisely,
you're right. You're right. Macarthur 7-0 HSC, and how about them Farmers? They've been impressive so far.
Well, on the other side of that sign, it says, "We want Judson." I guess they want to consolidate the state championship for 5A here in Texas.
Topher Roach to punt it away. And hits a good one. Inside the 5-yard line, and boy, I tell you what, in a game of field position, it's been all Lewisville. Lewisville's 2 drives have started inside of Macarthur territory, and Macarthur hasn't been able to get anything going offensively.
Well, now that decision to take the timeout looks pretty good since he kicked it down to the 1-yard line.
I told you it was a good decision.
You said it. Yes, you did.
Well, the 12,000 members of the Texas High School Coaches Association offer congratulations to both teams in today's game. The THSCA is also proud of our 63 years of dedicated service to the youth of Texas. The first down and 10 for Macarthur from the 9-yard line. Odell James on the keeper, stayed right behind the fullback and picks up a few. Pete Bonenberger made the stop, the 255-pound senior for the Lewisville Fighting Farmers. Odell James has rushed, as I said, for over 1,400 yards, 21 touchdowns, and he's thrown for over 1,100 yards.
You know, I was a little bit surprised with the way Macarthur started this ballgame offensively, trying to set up the pass, and then finally they go to what they do best, the option, and Odell James picks up 8 yards.
So second down, 2. Satish Hodge. Hodge back to the line of scrimmage, forget it. Jeff Branch, the first man to get to him, followed by Bonenberger again. We have called the name of Pete Bonenberger a few times this afternoon already.
Lewisville winning the battle of the trenches here with their defensive line. Satish Hodge is forced to move sideways rather than upfield. You'll see him going sideways, and you can't make any yardage that way. He's sideways, and they make the stop for no gain, or maybe a little bit of a loss, and I think we've got a 3rd-and-3 situation now.
You don't want your fullback going east and west. You want him going north and south.
Absolutely.
A 3rd down and 2. Big 3rd down for Macarthur. Garner on the delay. Garner has the first down and more out of across the 20-yard line, out to the 24. Zach Welton made the stop, and good job by the front 5 of Macarthur getting the job done in the trenches.
Oh, and a great job by Garner. Watch this spin move that allows him to break out of the tackle and get the first down. He's hit behind the line of scrimmage. Watch the spin move here, keeping his balance, and goes upfield. At that point, he didn't have it, but he was able to pick it up, and it's a 1st down for Macarthur. That's their first down of this ballgame.
Delbert Garner, 5 yards a carry today. He's rushed for nearly 1,400 yards himself. Quick hitter. Odell James complete Delbert Garner. And Garner
gets ahead for a couple, but that play just way too slow in development.
Absolutely. It was a possibility of a double pass. This was a lateral from James to Garner. Macarthur went what we call empty in the backfield. They had no running backs back there. You can see no backs behind Odell James. He throws a lateral here. This could have been another pass, and it looked like he might have wanted to throw it again. Nobody open, and it's a very, very short gain on a long pass play.
Blaine Herring, the first Fighting Farmer to get there. So second down and eight. Garner on the misdirection. Cuts it against the grain out to the 30-yard line, but another third down situation coming up. Ben Collinsworth made the hit, and that was all Delbert Garner because there wasn't a hole there.
That's a little short reverse. He put Garner out at the wing. You'll see him on the top of your screen. He comes back in motion on the reverse, a short reverse, and he gets a little bit of a hole, but he does a lot of spinning there and picks up 4 or 5 yards.
James will tuck it up and run. James has the first down out to the 41-yard line. Zach Welton made the hit, but that'll give you an idea just how talented that young man is.
Well, Macarthur on the move. Coach Alpert made the comment in this morning's paper that what Odell James brings to this team is when his receivers are covered, he can make something happen. You see that right here. He rolls out to his left, finds no receivers open, and moves it upfield for the first down and keeps this drive alive.
Jose Venegas made a great block out there, left tackle for the Macarthur Generals. First down and 10, another pitch pass. They'll try to throw it deep. It was knocked away. But Marcus Elizondo, the backup quarterback, had checked in at the wide receiver position, and he was trying to throw that one downfield.
Same play they tried to throw to Garner to the other side. This time they had a quarterback out to the left. You see it here. It's a lateral. He had Patterson streaking deep, but his arm was hit as he tried to throw the ball, but Patterson was pretty well covered downfield. I don't think this was going to be a successful play had he gotten it off.
Dwight Hunter coming on the safety blitz. You know, he fumbled, really, when he caught the ball, he didn't catch it cleanly. That's the first step to that play. Second down, 10 to go. Delbert Garner again. Garner back to the line of scrimmage. Dan Merritt, he has a broken growth plate. That's what he has in that left arm, but still playing.
And we've called his name several times here in this first quarter. That Lewisville defense, very effective at stopping the run. This is just the pitch sweep. Quarterback will just turn around and toss it to the tailback, but it was not very successful. Picked up no yards.
Third down, 10. Macarthur, 2 for 4 on the third down conversions. Odell James, he's got a gun, and he will gun it. Complete. They call it complete to Delbert Garner.
Boy, he threaded the needle with this pass. Garner on an out pattern at about 13 yards. Odell James goes back into the pocket, rolls a little bit to his left. Garner's running the out back to the left. He rolls a little left, sets up, and watch this bullet. Throws it through traffic. Ooh, just missed it. Nice catch by Garner going down on the carpet to pick up the ball, and the drive stays alive on a 3rd and 10 completion of 13 yards. Odell James pretty excited about that one. I said to you before the ball game, Kevin, I felt like the team that was better at throwing the football today could very well be the team that wins the game. So far, Macarthur is winning that battle.
That's the 8th catch of the season as you look at Delbert Garner's numbers. Again, they'll throw it. And this one is picked off to Dwight Hunter. Hunter down the sideline.
and finally down inside the 40-yard line. Satish Hodge made the tackle. One thing about Odell James, he has thrown 11 interceptions, a 30-yard return for Dwight Hunter, his 11th interception of the season.
As good as that last pass to Garner for the first down was, this one was equally as bad. He overthrows the receiver. You'll see it here, just a two-step drop, but he way overthrows the ball, hangs it up. Hunter just picks it off, picks it right out of the air and returns it 30 yards to give the Farmers great field position inside the Macarthur 40.
Lewisville has had the ball three times. All three times it started inside Macarthur territory. This one is sniffed out nicely. Waylon Holland tried to turn the corner, the 170-pound junior, but Stephen Glenn, the left defensive cornerback, came up and made the stop.
But not before Holland picked up 6 yards, and Nelson, once again, with those split-second decisions, got out there, saw that the contained man was coming toward him, so he pitches it to Holland, and it's a nice game for the Farmer.
Under 2 minutes to go in the first quarter. Lewisville with the football. They lead it 7-0. Brazil ahead for a couple more. Third down and short is coming up. Check it. That was Byron Mitchell on the carry.
Right. Mitchell just off left tackle on the misdirection there. Send the fullback one way, bring Mitchell off of his behind. And very short gain there. Still going to be a third two.
Byron Mitchell has rushed in this backfield. Byron Mitchell's rushed for 700 yards. Dwayne Brazil has rushed for 1,300 yards. And Waylon Holland has rushed for 600 yards. And then you got a quarterback that has rushed for 900 yards.
Who do you stop?
Looking for the third down conversion again. The keeper, Chad Nelson, pitches it back beautifully. It's fumbled, and Macarthur has the football. Charlie Foster got on it for the Generals of Macarthur. Byron Mitchell, I don't think, was expecting.
No, it was a surprise to Mitchell. This was a great play by Chad Nelson. As he's going down, he's still got his pitch man trailing him. And that was Byron Mitchell. But I don't think he saw the ball coming. He was not anticipating the football. It falls on the ground, and it stops the Lewisville drive. But watch it here. Great faking. Gets outside. He's got enough for the first down. But as he's going down, he wants more. Pitches it right to Mitchell. Looks like Mitchell did see it. He just dropped the football. And Macarthur will take over at the 23-yard line. That stops. Macarthur has just dodged a bullet, trailing 7-0, and Lewisville on the move, but fumble away the drive.
Turnovers are even. Odell James right behind the fullback across the 30 to the 32-yard line.
When you've got a quarterback the size of Odell James at 6'3 and 195, I really do like this play. Ride the fullback into the line and then follow him right through. It's just like a lead blocker, and you'll see it here. He rides the fullback 35 and then just gets right on his butt and heads on up the field. Picks up about 8 yards, second and two.
Like following an offensive guard that can run.
That's exactly right.
30 seconds to go in the first quarter. Try it again. Odell James, not this easy this time.
Looks like he'll be just a little bit short of the first down. Less than a yard short of the first down.
Shannon Brazil, the first man to get there.
That'll probably be the last play of the first quarter.
Under 10 seconds to go. You see it there on your screen. The time expire in the first quarter of play. So again, with Craig Way, a Gatorade sideline report. Craig?
Kevin, we're over here on the Lewisville sideline with a group known as the Rowdy Crowd. Now, why do they call you the Rowdy Crowd? I think you can hear why they're called the Rowdy Crowd, Kevin.
They've been rowdy so far. Leading 7-0, the Lewisville faithful. But Odell James wants to say something about that. Odell James has the first down on that big third down in one play. Zach Welton made the hit.
You know, even when James breaks loose and it looks like he may go a long way, I'm real impressed with Lewisville's quickness and speed. They shut it down quicker than you would expect. It looks like it's going to be a much bigger play than actually happens. That time he picked up 4 or 5 yards. It looked like he'd go a long way.
Just underway in the second quarter with Craig Way and Dave Elmendorf. I'm Kevin Eschenfelder. Happy holidays to you from all of us at HSE. And glad you can be with us for the Texas 5A Division II State Championship. This one's complete. Raymond Robinson, and Robinson could go. inside the 20 to the 19-yard line to White. Hunter finally caught up with him. A gain of 42 yards.
You run the option, you run the option, you run the option, and then you fake the option and you stand up and throw the ball to a big, fast tight end. Watch him fake it here. Fake to the fullback, stand up and throw the football. And it's a foot race. Eric Otsuji on the way. He's taken down at the last minute, the last line of defense, Dwight Hunter.
Raymond Robinson at 6'2", 205. A big target there at tight end. Odell James hurdles the 15 down to the 10-yard line, and the Macarthur Generals are rolling. Zach Welton knocked him off his feet.
Here it is again. That same fullback lead. This time Odell James very successful with it, almost a first down. Great play. You've got a good blocking fullback. Just fake to him and then follow him right through the hole.
A gain of 9, second down and 1. From the 10-yard line, quarterback sneak. They picked up the first down. So now it'll be first down and goal as they mark him down, I believe, at the 8-yard line. It's been the Odell James show so far, both good and bad. He's thrown an interception. He's thrown for a big pass play. Bob Alpert extremely excited about this young man. He'll have him for two more seasons after this one.
He really showed a lot of poise on that big completion to Raymond Robinson.
From the 8-yard line, Odell James, touchdown Macarthur. The 22nd touchdown of the season for Odell James.
This looked like the parting of the Red Sea right up the middle. It's like a little quarterback draw. He just steps back and then heads up field, and it's a touchdown for Macarthur. The point could tie it.
David Saldivar. It's blocked. This is only the second game David Saldivar has been able to kick. Last week when he attempted an extra point, he missed it.
It looks like a jailbreak from the left, from the right side here. Number 24 and number 23 both in there.
It looked like three people got to it. 10:04 to go, a new score. The Farmers lead it.
And run it right up the middle. And one of the defensive backs for Lewisville, that would be Dwight Hunter. Watch it here.
Watch number three.
I think he thinks that the 5-yard line is the goal line. He just stops and doesn't make the tackle. And Odell James goes into the end zone. He'll take some razzing about that one when they look at this film. He probably thought the 5-yard line was a goal line and didn't want to hit him after he crossed the goal line.
There's Dwight Hunter right there, but he had a big interception earlier in this ball game. Dwight Hunter and LaDarren McClain back deep.
You know, there's been a lot of talk about Macarthur and the trouble they've gone through all season long. They lost 5 starters to no pass, no play, and a lot of those were in the offensive line, so they've had problems there, but they've come back from all of the adversity, and here they are playing in the state championship game.
David Saldivar will kick it away for Bob Alpert's crew. Saldivar, like I said, the first game he was ever kicked was last week on a varsity level. Low liner. This is going to work out real well. LaDarren McClain all the way back at the 5. I call that one out to the 13-yard line.
You know what this reminds us of is last week, the first kickoff of the second half.
Armin Love was down there on the coverage. Much harder to field a kick that is rolling around like that, the squib kick. Macarthur's drive, 7 plays, 76 yards, and Odell James takes it in from 8 yards out. Took a little less than 3 minutes off the clock.
Well, Lewisville winning. Lewisville winning the battle of field position, and making Macarthur go a long way to get it. And you've got those.
Give you an idea of how Lewisville has won the field position ball game. It's been like this. They have started at the Macarthur 29 at midfield and the Macarthur 39-yard line. But now they'll Oilers and Houston Astros. And, oh, by the way, speaking of the Houston Astros, HSE's got a special show for all you baseball fans in the audience. It's called Astros Up Close, a preview of the 1994 Houston Astros. Join Bill Worrell. He will host this special two-hour sports talk show, and you'll get your chance to talk with general manager Bob Watson, new skipper Terry Collins. So if you want to know what's happening this offseason in baseball, tune into Astros Up Close Wednesday night at 8 on HSE. Macarthur has gotten the job done offensively, but on the scoreboard, Lewisville leads it 7-6.
Lewisville scoring on the second play of their first possession, and they've had been hard-pressed to move the football since. Tried a dive right up the middle that time. Looks like they'll have an injured player down on the field.
Tommy Kilman has come in and replaced Buddy Phillips. A second down and six. Brazil. Well, Brazil is rocked after a gain of about four. It's going to be a third down coming up. If you just joined us, Lewisville scored on the second play of their first possession on a 39-yard run by their quarterback, Chad Nelson. But since then, in their last four drives, they have gone three plays and punt, two plays and a fumble, and three plays and punt.
And the best drive of those four was the one where they fumbled. They were on their way. It was a good play. Nelson had picked up the first down when they fumbled.
Lewisville has not converted on third down today. Nelson won't convert this time either. Don Sewell, the outside linebacker, the first man to get there.
Boy, it so often happens when you've got two high-powered offenses, you tend to forget the defense. We've got a defensive struggle here, even though we've got two great offenses on the field. Watch it here. It's going to be very close. Fake to Brazil, and then follow it upfield. He moved back inside. It looks like he may have gotten just enough for the first down. Nope, they'll say it's short by about a yard, a little less than a yard.
Lewisville will punt. That's Joseph Eaton also in there on the play for Macarthur. As you look at the replay, Eaton, 180-pound junior. Now Lewisville to punt. Topher Roach. As Delbert Garner and David Patterson sit in a dual safety, and here's a fake. Topher Roach, did he get the first down? He sure did.
Depending on his play, to be right at the 40-yard line, which is going to be about a foot past the stick. I don't think Macarthur was surprised. It was just good execution on the part of Topher Roach. He found a hole where he could pick up 2 feet.
Boy,
take a look here. Back there to punt. Nice snap. He looks ahead. Oh, pulls it down. Says, I think I'll try to pick up the first down. An excellent effort there to dive forward to get the first down at the 40-yard line.
I would be curious to know if that play was called in the huddle. Handed off, first man through again, Dwayne Brazil.
Brazil, their leading rusher, picks up another five.
Sewell with the stop. Second down and five coming as we count down to 3:45 to go at halftime. I want to remind you to be sure and stay with us at halftime. We'll take a look at both the Macarthur General Marching Band and the Lewisville Fighting Farmer Marching Band. That's all coming up at halftime. Also, Craig Way will have some special guests stopping by. Brazil has been kept in check this afternoon. Six carries, the 22 yards you saw. Second down and five. Now here comes Chad Nelson, and Nelson at the 40. It's a foot race, and Chad Nelson will go all the way. Touchdown, Lewisville. 55 yards.
Boy, is he exciting to watch. He takes this one almost right up the middle. They broke the bone, put both halfbacks as wingbacks, brought one in motion, faked to the fullback, and then went back to the opposite direction. Started to the right, went back left, just a little sidestep up the middle, and once he broke into the clear, there was nobody that was going to catch him. He's rushed four times for 103 yards and has scored both touchdowns for Lewisville.
And the kick is good. They're going to have a roughing the kicker call as well. So Chad Nelson over 100 yards, and we still have 3 minutes to go in the first quarter. The Fighting Farmers lead it 14-6 in this Texas 5A Division II state championship.
Well, the point was good, and there'll be a penalty.
5 yard running into the kicker call on the kickoff.
They'll enforce that on the kickoff. Now take a look here as Chad Nelson, see the motion man, face to the fullback, then goes back the other way. The hole opens up great, and once he's in the clear in the secondary, nobody's going to catch him. He is off to the races. You see Charlie Foster trying to catch up to him, but he's not going to get there.
Running into the kicker. 5 yard penalty.
This is an exciting runner.
One's good.
Starts it to the left, cuts it back to the right, and nobody's going to catch it. Chad Nelson for the second touchdown for Lewisville, giving them a lead of 14-6.
That is the, there is Chad Nelson, and he is the fastest man in that backfield with that 4-5 speed. He showed it right there. He rushed for 141 yards last week versus Temple and 2 touchdowns. Right now he's already over 100 yards and has 2 touchdowns and only a half of football. That is the 16th touchdown of the season for Chad Nelson.
Well, and for the season, he's averaging 7.6 yards a carry. Got 932 yards on 122 carries. 14 touchdowns, now he has 16.
Topher Roach will kick it away. To be farmers, and that's the young man right there that really made that possible. It was his fake punt, Topher Roach, that got the first down, and one play later, here's a squib kick. It almost worked against Lewisville big time, but it's going to be great field position for Macarthur as Raymond Robinson played heads up and ran it back out near midfield out to the 47-yard line.
Lewisville trying a little bit of a trick play there. I don't know if they wanted to try to run under it or they thought they could get down and cover it, but the ball only went down to about the 35-yard line. So regardless, Macarthur was going to get good field position. And Robinson wisely moved it up to the 47-yard line.
3:07 to play in the first quarter. 14-6, Lewisville leading Macarthur. Delbert Garner hit at the line of scrimmage, will fall forward for a gain of 3. It was a blitzing Shannon Brazil who made the stop.
Odell James tripped as he was trying to go back and give the ball to the fullback. I think he might have been stepped on by one of his linemen. He was. His center stepped on his foot. He was falling down as he tries to give the ball to Garner, and it's a short gain of about 2 yards.
Out to midfield. 2.5 to go, first quarter. Second down and 7. Looking downfield big time. Caught by Raymond Robinson. Touchdown, Macarthur.
This was not poor coverage. Robinson just running a streak pattern right down the middle of the field. Blaine Herring, the strong safety, is in good position. Take a look at it here. Odell James goes back. Robinson running right down the middle of the field, but look at number 10, Blaine Herring. He has good position. He just misses the football. Robinson, with great concentration, pulls it down and takes it in for the touch. Take a look again. Little play action fake. But from this angle, you'll be able to see that Herring could have gotten a hand on it. But Robinson, with excellent concentration, nobody could stop him. He takes it in for the touch.
Watch Odell James, only a sophomore. Takes a look at it.
There. Oh, yeah, he got it.
Just another day at the office, fellas.
Just another 50-yard touchdown pass.
Now he's going to smile.
Of course, now Macarthur, trailing by 2, will attempt the 2-point conversion.
Called a timeout. Huddling up a reception, 1 touchdown.
And how about Raymond Robinson there? Two receptions for 94 yards and a touchdown.
They're going for the two-point conversion and the tie. And it's good. Delbert Garner. And we have got a tie ball game with 2:14 to go.
Sophomore, but he's likely to get some footballs today.
David Saldivar kicking it away. Dwight Hunter. To the 35, out to the 38-yard line. Lewisville with 2:18 on the clock to work with here in the first half, but that has really not been much of a factor in this ball game at all, as it's been a big play offense for Lewisville. Their quarterback, Chad Nelson, scoring from 38 yards and 55 yards out. Ray Hudson will make the call. And this will back up Lewisville 15 yards.
Ooh, they could ill afford that. They had pretty good field position outside the 35.
Let's check in with Craig Way, a sideline report. Craig?
Kevin, you know, it was quiet over here on the Macarthur sideline after that 55-yard touchdown run by...
They'll throw this one incomplete. Broken up nicely and almost intercepted by Stephen Glenn.
Trying to run the fade pattern here. Stephen Glenn would have nothing to do with that. Just trying to drop it over the defender, but he didn't get it far enough. Stephen Glenn gets a hand on it, and he thinks he should have had an interception. Second and 10.
Chad Nelson has tried to throw it twice. He is 0 of 2 in the passing department. Second down, 10. Back to the option. Chad Nelson again, and Nelson cuts it up again big time. To the 46-yard line goes Chad Nelson. Charlie Foster saved another touchdown. A gain of 23 yards.
What's so impressive about Chad Nelson, well, two things. He makes great decisions. Watch him here. He decides to keep it. He's so quick through the hole. And once he gets into the secondary, he's so quick to make his move, avoiding a couple of tacklers here and picking up 23 yards, moving the ball way down the field and to the 46-yard line.
After taking that last one.
It's been a well-played game as well. Only one penalty in the game, and that was the one, the 15-yarder on the kickoff just a while ago.
Each team has only turned it over one time. Tied at 14. Brazil breaks it big. Down near the 30-yard line. That is one special fullback right there.
Well, we told you earlier what I was impressed with was his size. 220 pounds, and watch him ramble through the secondary. Big hole opens up. And he rambles over a defender, finally goes down, but not before he picked up big yardage.
23.
Another 23. Back-to-back 23-yard gains, one by Nelson, one by Brazil.
Under 2 minutes to play, first half. From the 31-yard line, again, Chad Nelson turns the corner down to the 25-yard line. He's knocked down there by Joseph Eaton and Don Sewell on the outside. Clock continuing to run, under a minute 40.
I don't know what the wake-up call was for these offensive teams, but they are both awake now and moving the football extremely well. Chad Nelson on the option, with Macarthur on the veer option and throwing the football, but both teams moving the ball at will during the second quarter.
This time, Nelson cuts it up for a couple more. Lewisville with a strong kicking game, if that's what you're starting to think about at this point of the game, with 67 seconds left in the first quarter.
That's that last play, a pitch to Waylon Holland.
Between Topher Roach and Alan Blacketer, Lewisville not afraid to go for field goals inside of 45 yards.
They're certainly in field goal range now.
And Bob Alpert wants to talk to his defense. Third down and 2.
Well, it really looks more like a short 2, about 1.5.
We have not converted a third down today. Now they have.
Yes, they have. Give it to the big fella.
Brazil inside the 20 to the 19-yard line. Clock stops to set the chains with 61 seconds remaining.
Nelson trying to get a play. Wants to know what Coach Gage wants him to run here in this critical situation. A little over a minute left. Only one timeout remaining. And trying to drive for the go-ahead score before the half ends.
The reverse. McLean. At the 10, shakes a man and stepped out of bounds. At the 10-yard line, LaDarren McLean, 170-pound sophomore. He's a backup quarterback. He's just so athletic, they need to get him in the backfield.
This is a reverse, and there's always one man assigned defensively to stop the play. This time it was Charlie Foster, but he was unable to stop it. And LaDarren McLean will go down inside the 10-yard line, or right about the 9-yard line, almost a first down. It'll be second and one, but the clock becomes a factor. 39 seconds, and one timeout remaining for Lewisville.
Second down, one. They'll throw it, complete. Touchdown, Lewisville. Byron Mitchell. Touchdown number 11 of the season comes with 33 seconds to go in the first half.
It's a double level pattern. Chad Nelson rolls to his right. He sends Martin Simmons deep into the end zone and sends Nelson out into the flat. He chose Nelson, hits him with the football. Nelson just nudges over the goal line, and it's a touch. Or was it? It was Mitchell that caught the touchdown.
Point after is good. So more fireworks with 33 seconds left. And then that touchdown pass of 10 yards. Chad Nelson to Byron Mitchell. David Patterson fields it at the 5.
Touched his knee to the ground.
Well, if you had to do that, it's best to do it with only 30 seconds to play. We've got to get in motion and weren't exactly sure where to be, but it ended up with 7 points.
Good result, and we talked about these offenses waking up. 22 points scored in the last 2 minutes and 30 seconds of this ballgame.
Odell James out to the 15-yard line. You think at your own 5-yard line with 30 seconds to play in the half, you'd fall on it and go into the locker room, but not the case with these two explosive offense. As Odell James shows you right there, he goes ahead for a gain of 10 yards.
When you've got James and Garner with that type of explosive potential, why not go for it? You're keeping the ball on the ground anyway. The clock will run out, and it will run out here. They're down to 12 seconds. Maybe get one more play off if they hustle.
One more play, they hand it off to Garner, and Garner for a couple, and with that, we will go to intermission. They're playing for a Texas 5A division.
For that
9-yard
touchdown. Yes.
Macarthur, though, very successful through the air, and you say that may be one of the most surprising parts of this ballgame for you.
Well, Raymond Robinson with 2 catches for 94 yards. Odell James has thrown for a total of 110. I think that's a big surprise, and that's what's kept Macarthur in the ballgame.
3 yards difference in the total yards and the time of possession, just a little over 2 minutes difference. So the halftime statistics, as even as the first half score, as Lewisville leads it by a score of 21. David Saldivar hits a low one, picked up by Reggie Crawford, and Crawford loses yardage on the return. Great special teams play for Macarthur. It was Mr. Johnson, and I kid you not, that's his name, Mr. Johnson, down on the coverage.
You know, Kevin, another changeup. This time they had Raymond Robinson kicking off the football this time, and he either had on a tennis shoe or he had on no shoe when he kicked this football. But Lewisville will take possession down around their 25-yard line. We have a Lewisville player down on the field, and I think he'll take that just about any day, over a 20-yard average.
So here we go in the second half for a state 5A Division II championship. Lewisville leading by 7. Brazil in the middle. Hesitated for a moment. The hole opened up. He picks up 3 or 4. Don Sewell made the tackle for Aldine Macarthur. Big number 33, a 215-pound junior.
Watch 33 come up from his position back there in the secondary. Don Sewell good reaction up to stop a big bruising fullback for Lewisville.
A gain of three, second down, seven. Again, Brazil, right up the middle. Hit hard, but still able to pick up good yardage on a fullback dive. That's what we talked about earlier, how unusual it is for the leading rusher in a wishbone attack to be the fullback.
Well, normally in the wishbone, the quarterback, the defense will take away the fullback to start with, and it'll be the quarterback and the pitch man that will get the football. But in many cases, or more cases than not this year for Lewisville, Chad Nelson has left the ball in the belly of the fullback, and he's their leading rusher.
Big third down, just underway in the second half. Line to make the 35. Nelson cuts it up, and I believe he got there just enough for a first down. Don Sewell was there around his waist. They'll move the sticks. That's big for Lewisville.
He pulls it out. You see that time he just stuck it in and pulled it out and just barely gets over the 35-yard line. And that will be enough for a first down.
Lewisville leading by seven. They've led all the way in this ball game. It was tied at 14 at one point. Misdirection. Byron Mitchell has good yardage across the 40-yard line out to the 42-yard line. Again, Armin Love and Kermit Woods teaming up, and Don Sewell has been very active here in the second half.
I love the way they have the misdirection. They send Reggie Crawford in motion to the right side and then bring Mitchell back underneath him right up the middle for a nice gain of 5 yards. See Sewell in there again on the tackle.
Mitchell, a guy who rushed for 700 yards this season. But today, been very quiet. Second down, five. Straight up the middle again. Brazil close to another first down. And right now, as far as this drive is concerned, the battle in the trenches is being won by Lewisville as far as the offensive line against the defensive line.
Absolutely. Watch Brazil with just raw power right up the middle. A little reverse out of there. Brazil with a nice hole, but good power, and he gets the first down for Lewisville. The story of the first half was Chad Nelson keeping the ball and running for big yardage. The story here in the second half is running the football up the middle and controlling the clock for Lewisville.
They try it again. This is Byron Mitchell, and Mitchell with big yardage.
That'll certainly improve his numbers. He was 4 carries for 8 yards.
Armin Love finally made the tackle. A gain of 15 yards.
That will certainly improve your average. Watch it here, Chad Nelson. Good block on Sewell. He breaks right off of him. And then he shows good power downfield. He now has 5 carries for 24. That average getting better.
So inside the 40-yard line, call it the 38. Byron Mitchell getting the numbers up here in the second half. Brazil right up the middle, fighting his way near the 30-yard line down to the 31. Sewell and Harvey Walker making the hit, but not before a gain of 8 on first down.
You know, I'm not sure that this is conscious, but it's almost like they had 2 separate game plans. The first half to feature Nelson and make Macarthur think about defending Nelson on the quarterback keep and the pitch. The second half, come back and run the ball up the middle with Brazil, and Macarthur not able to stop that so far.
Option, Nelson hit at the line of scrimmage, maybe a couple. He'll be close to the first down. Shadrick George was the first man to get to him, the nose tackle at 5'10", 220 pounds. He's a senior.
Now that they're focusing on running the ball up between the tackles, we're seeing a lot more of number 33, Don Sewell. He is really around the ball.
Now I think if you're Macarthur, though, those defensive backs started creeping closer and closer to the line of scrimmage.
Could be time for a play action pass. This is a good time for it. Third and one.
For Brazil. Brazil hit and handed down at the 14-yard line. Stephen Glenn stopped the touchdown on a third down and one. Brazil goes for 15.
Another 15 yards for Dwayne Brazil right up the middle. Reverses out, and look at him ramble into the secondary. Nobody touches him until he gets down to the 15-yard line. Let's look at it from another angle. He'll be coming right at you, right up the middle. Look at that hole. Somebody blocks Sowell out of the picture. Nice misdirection there, and look at Brazil. He's rambled inside the 15.
They try it again. Dwayne Brazil getting down, fighting his way to the 10-yard line. Freddie Hudson, the man on the bottom of the stack, he is a load. Dwayne Brazil is the kind of guy at 225 pounds that can wear a defense down.
Absolutely, and I'm going to tell you exactly what Coach Gage was telling Lewisville, the reason they were late getting out here. He said, we're going to go and take it to them here on this first drive. We're going to run it right up the middle, and we're going to make them stop us. Mano a mano, and it has not happened. Lewisville executing extremely well here in this drive.
But from the 11-yard line, a second down, the line to make is the 4. Hand it off, touchdown, Lewisville. Byron Mitchell with a huge hole.
Wow. Lewisville unstoppable in this drive, all on the ground, mostly Dwayne Brazil, but Mitchell goes the last 13 yards for the touchdown. Gives Lewisville a bulging lead, their biggest lead of the day.
Looking to make it a 2-touchdown lead. Topher Roach is perfect. And so with 6:29 to go in the third quarter, a methodical Lewisville drive. They keep it on the ground the whole way, and they lead it by a...
Watch this scamper right up the middle. Byron Mitchell following his lead blocker, and nobody touches him. Right into the end zone.
One thing about
watch this one now coming at you. Watch this block by Waylon Holland on Sowell. Creams him out of the hole. Nice lead block. And Mitchell takes it in for the touchdown.
Byron Mitchell, his 12th touchdown of the season. Only a junior. He'll be back next year at 185 pounds. Blackister to kick it away. This was Delbert Garner trying to get outside. Garner hurdles the 30 out to the 40-yard line. The 42 is a good field position for Macarthur to start here in the second half.
Special teams so important. They can bring you back. He's going to take this down the right sideline, and you'll see that all of the containment for Lewisville is lost. Good block there. Holland out in front trying to hit somebody. Little cutback there for Garner, but good field position for Macarthur here on this kickoff following the touchdown that gave Lewisville a 2-touchdown lead, and Macarthur will start at the 42-yard line.
What a drive for Lewisville. 11 plays, 75 yards, all on the ground. A first down and 10. Macarthur, look for the reverse. Here it comes. David Patterson, and Patterson hitting the backfield. Nothing doing. Zeb Cornist was not fooled one bit.
Odell James trying to get the big block on Cornist, but he didn't get any help from Patterson. Patterson had taken this ball outside. He could have set up the block on Cornist. Take a look at it here. Here's the reverse, and Odell James trying to get the block out there, but see how Patterson came inside rather than taking it outside, made the block impossible. Cornish with a big play for a 5-yard loss.
Zeb Cornish, a 215-pound junior. He leads this team in sacks. Second down, 14. Odell James looking to throw, guns it. In and out of the hands. That was almost picked off by Brazil.
Shannon Brazil, Dwayne Brazil's brother. He's very active. He's only a sophomore. They say he's a great one.
Give you an idea how good he is versus Midland Lee as we take
a
look at it.
Watch his mobility. He's getting out there, reads the quarterback's eyes, and he's going to have to work a little on his hands. But boy, he was in great position.
Hit him right in the head. Against Midland Lee, he had 18 tackles, one interception, and a fumble recovery for a touchdown. Not a bad day at the office.
Big third down conversion here for Macarthur on third and 15. They're 4-for-7 in third down conversion.
The delay, Delbert Garner. Garner has the first down.
They're five for eight in third down conversions. And this one, a big one. It keeps the drive alive, trailing by two touchdowns, picks up 15.
A third down and 14, and he got 15.
Look at him fly through the hole. Good blocking from Macarthur. Keeps the drive alive and moves Macarthur into Lewisville territory.
Counting down to 5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Good day for Delbert Garner. Odell James goes ahead for a gain of about four.
Big tackle there by Zach Welton. James following his fullback through the hole. Zach Welton stopping him after a relatively short game. That's Satish Hodge who's leading that play for Odell James.
So second down and six. Again, the delay. Garner down to the 40-yard line. Well, he is very shifty. He has great lateral movement. He could have lost a couple on that play. Blaine Herring and Dan Merritt finally made the tackle.
What's impressive about this play is, from the defensive standpoint, Blaine Herring holding his containment to keep Garner from getting outside. And then he keeps him inside so his pursuit can catch up and stops him for a relatively short gain. And he'll set up a third and about four.
Big third down. 36 is the line to make. Odell James on the keeper all the way. James has the first down and more. James will score. How in the world?
Odell James doing his Chad Nelson imitation. Scores from 40 yards out. And folks, when I tell you he ran through the entire Lewisville team, believe me. Great run by Odell James. Watch him. There are several Lewisville players who are going to have a clean shot at him. He's going to avoid him. It's just a rollout. He was never going to throw the football. He just bounces off a tackler after tackler and takes it in for the touchdown.
Now for the two-point conversion. Odell James. Did he get in?
Yes, he did.
Went for two and got it.
Now that's an interesting call to go for two at this point in the ballgame.
And now we've got a six-point game with 3:35 to go. We're going to take a timeout at the Astrodome. We've got a good one. Lewisville.
This is the Odell James show. It's a rollout all the way. He's not going to throw the football. And he bounces off of three or four different Lewisville tacklers with clean shots at him and waltzes into the end zone for the touchdown. And Macarthur, without an extra point kicker, goes for two. James keeps the ball on the option, faked the option, but he was going to keep it all the way. And just raw power, this sophomore gets it in for the two-point conversion. We've got a six-point game. And James now, with that 40-yard touchdown scamper, is 15 carries for 109 yards. He's now broken the 100-yard mark himself.
That is the first time all season that Lewisville has had anyone rush kinds of trouble back at the 20-yard line. That's the first time this season that Lewisville has allowed 100 yards to any opposing back.
Well, and it was Odell James, the super sophomore from Macarthur. That return by John Carroll picked up the squib kick. Once again, Raymond Robinson kicking the ball. Picked up the squib kick. Take a look at the drive there. Six plays, 58 yards for Macarthur. And, of course, 40 of those 58 coming on that great run by Odell James.
And Odell James taking it in for the two-point conversion to make it a six-point ball game at 28-22. The folks in red chanting defense. Handed off right up the middle. Brazil for a couple. A big play like that can certainly fire your defense up. And that's what Macarthur needs right now.
We'll have a timeout down on the field. It looks like officials timeout. Oh,
you stop it.
That's exactly right. And, of course, this time Macarthur did, showing the playing with great emotion on that play following the big touchdown for Macarthur to pull within six.
Renard Reeves has checked in to the defensive lineup for Macarthur. And again, Brazil right up the middle, hard hitting. He'll make it a third down and short coming up. Don Sewell made the stop. We've called Don Sewell's name a lot this afternoon.
One of the signs of a good option quarterback, particularly the wishbone, is his faking is so good that they continually tackle him when he's given the ball away. I've seen that several times from Chad Nelson when he's given the ball to Brazil and continues his fake, and still the Macarthur Generals are attacking Chad Nelson as if he had the ball.
Big third down. Brazil hitting the backfield, gets to the line of scrimmage, and no more. Joseph Eaton and Anthony Williams team up to make the play.
Anthony Williams anxious to get back into the ball game. Watch him stuff this play. Anthony Williams working off the nose. What a big play. Great quickness for his huge size. Anthony Williams makes the play by himself.
So a fourth down coming up. Lewisville will have to punt it away. Again, Topher Roach comes in, and Macarthur should have excellent field position out of this as Patterson and Garner go deep. Low liner, and a fair catch called for. I have a feeling if David Patterson had that one back, he would like to have returned that one.
That was definitely a return ball. It wasn't very deep. It was only a 29-yard punt, but it was a low-line drive, as you said, and that's a returnable ball.
All right, we're time out on the field. We'll take it with him. We've got a ball game. Lewis again with Craig Way.
Craig, Kevin here on the Lewisville sideline. The message for the Fighting Farmer offensive lineman, you got to tighten it up. Got to do a better job of protecting inside running like they did on the earlier drive. Macarthur had it figured out on this last drive, and the momentum shift now goes back across the opposite side of the field to the Generals.
Right about that, and a good field position does as well. First down and 10 from the 43-yard line. Best field position of the day. Delbert Garner, flags fly, crosses the 45-yard line out to the 47.
That one likely a holding call based upon where the flag flew, but we'll take a look here and see what the officials have to say.
Called it Mr. Elmendorf.
Big drive here for both teams. Got a 6-point game. Macarthur has some momentum. And this holding penalty will certainly not help that momentum. Put them in a hole at first and 20.
Holding, red team, 10-yard penalty, replay, first down.
This is the first offensive penalty of the ball game. Somebody caught for the hole on the trap play.
Could be 57 there.
Like Shadrick George.
Kind of blocked out of the play. It was hard to see. That's why the official on the other side of the line called it.
Very well played ball game. Only two penalties. Odell James cutting it up near midfield.
I told you earlier in the ball game that the way to stop the option is you have to assign somebody to each player in the option. Nobody assigned to Odell James here. He just turns it upfield. Watch him. There's nobody around him. Nobody to even contest him. He just turns it upfield and picks up 16.
It was a 15-yard penalty. And they've come right back with a 16-yard game. Now James getting near 130 yards rushing.
He and Nelson are pretty well neck and neck now.
Delbert Garner with a big hole. Garner breaks outside, 35-yard line down at the 34. Jason Cotton saved a touchdown.
One of the great things about high school football, the ebb and flow of emotion. Emotional Macarthur, but look at this hole. It's a cutback, a counter. What a nice move there. Left the defender standing in his tracks. Another nice move there. Garner moving the ball deep into Lewisville territory inside the 35. Watch this move. That's what you call on the defensive side a shoe duster. All he got was a little dust of his shoes, and away Garner went deeper into Lewisville territory.
Last play of the third quarter. Zeb Cornist would have nothing to do with it. Got a hold of Odell James and wasn't going to let go. And to Odell James's credit, while he's being spun around, he didn't try to pitch the football. He just held on to it.
Now take your loss and come back.
But we will come back with afternoon on HSE. 28-22 the count. Well, the 12,000 members of the Texas High School Coaches Association offer congratulations to both teams in today's game. The THSCA is also proud of our 64 years of dedicated service to the youth of Texas. What a ball game we have had so far. As the score would indicate, Odell James, James to the 30-yard line. James could go all the way. Pushed out of bounds inside the 10.
Dwight Hunter there on the spot to stop the touchdown. But James all the way down to the 7-yard line. Faked it one way and went back the other. Watch, he'll turn to his left and then go back to the right side. Bounces off of a couple of tacklers again, breaking tackles. And only Dwight Hunter down the field was able to keep him from scoring.
29 yards on the carry, now 155 yards on the day for Odell James. First and goal from the 7. James hitting the backfield and racked up. He may lose a couple. Jeff Branch, the first guy to get there. Also, Pete Bonenberger.
Pete Bonenberger, the leading tackle of the first half, was the first one to get there. He catches this one from behind, coming right at you. Bonenberger coming from the back right there. Wraps him up. Got some help from Jeff Branch. Big play defensively for Lewisville. Second and goal for Macarthur.
From the 8-yard line. Odell James option. Delbert Garner cuts it up and down to the goal line. Inside the 1. John Carroll and Jeff Branch for the stop. But Odell James with a great lateral movement strings it outside and cuts against the grain.
The great thing about Garner is nobody ever gets a solid shot on him. Watch him avoid tackles here. Nobody really gets a clean hit, and he takes it all the way down to the 1-yard line.
The ball inside the 1. Third down, goal to go. Quarterback sneak. Touchdown, Macarthur.
Macarthur in this drive overcame so much. If you'll remember back, the first play of this possession, they had a holding call. They were faced with first and 20, and then they started the second chapter of the Odell James show.
Through.
He's been kicking on the kickoffs since the second half started. He's done the kickoff twice.
Marcus Elizondo on the hold. This is for the lead. And he's good. Who would have ever thought so much drama could come from an extra point? But it gives the Generals a 29-28 lead over the Fighting Farmers. And for the first time today, Macarthur has a lead with 10:38 to go. A drive, and for the third time today, Odell James goes into the end zone, takes 2:57 off the clock. They go 67 yards in 7 plays. Raymond Robinson to kick it away again. He kicks this one out of bounds.
You know, he kicked that extra point. He got a little cocky. You know, he's been squib kicking the ball. And I thought, well, you know, I'm a pretty good kicker now. I've kicked an extra point. I'll kick it off. And he kicks it out of bounds. And they'll penalize Macarthur 5 yards and have Raymond Robinson do it again.
There is Odell James. Just to give you an idea of what he has done today. No statistics. Just think about this. 3 touchdown runs. 1 touchdown pass. He's thrown for an extra point. He's run for an extra point. So all told, he is accounted for 28 of the Generals' 29 points.
And the 29th point came from Raymond Robinson. The lone PAT that they've kicked here today. And boy, the things you take for granted. Just generally speaking, you think, well, the touchdown is worth 7 points, but not so today. We've had several of them that are worth 8 and a few of them that have been worth 6 today.
15 unanswered points for the MacArthur Generals. And now the Farmers of Lewisville trying to answer back. They go to Brazil out to the 35-yard line. A pickup of 5 on first down. Second and 5 coming. You got to like your chances when you can pick up 5 on first down.
Well, no panic on the part of Lewisville. They're sticking with what got them here. Give the ball to Dwayne Brazil, their leading rusher. I'm sure we'll see some more of Chad Nelson on the keeper, but they're staying with their game plan, and as they should. It's a one-point game at this point. It's anybody's ball game.
I don't think Nelson's run the ball here in the second half. Again, Brazil out to the 40-yard line. Picked up 5 on first down to the 35. Then on second down from the 35, picks up 5 again out to the 40.
And with runs like that, 5 yards at a whack, you know why Chad Nelson is not keeping the football. That's available. He'll hand it off, just leave it with Brazil. And look at the power. Great leg drive from Brazil. Made him their leading rusher this year, over 1,300 yards and 13 touchdowns. 16 touchdowns.
It is just short of a first down. Inches. Fumble the snap, hit the backfield, but a great job by Waylon Holland. Holland could have lost 3 on third down and inches. Instead, spins off a man and picks up a first down.
Oh, he shows great balance here. This play was not destined to make anything. Chad Nelson fumbles the snap. Watch him here. He'll fumble the snap. But then Waylon Holland, with a great spin move, somehow he keeps his balance and picks it up. Anthony Williams there in the backfield.
Hit him 3 yards deep in the backfield. Counting down to 9 minutes to play in the ball game. Brazil in MacArthur territory, down at the 45-yard line. Don Sewell had a big part of that jersey, and that was able to pull him down. A gain of 14 yards for Dwayne Brazil.
Take a look at it here, right up the middle, once again to Brazil, a reverse out. And where is that tearaway jersey when you need it? He hangs on, the jersey doesn't rip, and Brazil will go down. He could have made a lot more had not Sewell held on to the jersey. 14-yard gain.
Another first down. This time Nelson will keep it. And Nelson goes for a gain of 3 or 4. He is racked up hard by Mr. Johnson and Armin Love.
Nelson has carried the ball. I think he probably wanted to give Dwayne Brazil a little bit of a rest. He's been the workhorse here early in this possession.
Waylon Holland has had 1 carry on this possession. Byron Mitchell has not. So Dwayne Brazil has been the workhorse. Like you said, he's carried it every play except for 2 on this drive. Here they go again. Byron Mitchell off tackle will bring up a 3rd down, short of the first down.
Of course, Lewisville now in 4 down territory. They trail by 1, but they must keep this drive alive. Lewisville now with 313 yards rushing.
Against a defense that was only giving up 193 yards a game total.
We said we'd give you offensive football today, and you've certainly got it.
Option Nelson has the first down and more. Down to the 3-yard line. Chad Nelson, what a game breaker. Armin Love saved the touchdown.
On a short yardage play, Nelson runs the option. He fakes it to Brazil. Watch him cut it back. He'll start it to the left, fake it to Brazil. Watch him cut it back over the middle now. Good move here to get back to the middle. Picks up a block. No, he doesn't. He just outruns everybody. Gets it down to the 2. You're from right behind him here. Turn it upfield. Chad, there you go. Now he'll cut it back to the right, get down to the middle. And a game-saving tackle there.
By Armin Love.
By Armin
Love. Brazil, touchdown, Lewisville.
They stuck with what they needed to do. Didn't panic. Moved the ball down the field methodically. Combination of Brazil and Nelson. They stick it into the end zone, and now they will probably go for 2.
A As we now have a 34-29 game. You're right, they will go for two. 6:58 to play. Well, Christmas Eve on HSE, we're going to be bringing you a special high school match. 6:29, the score. You have seen an excellent football game this afternoon.
If you like offensive football, you couldn't ask for much more than this.
Not a lot of defense.
Early in the game,
when they
surfaced.
When the emotions were running high.
Then it disappeared.
Adrenaline was pumping. But then shortly after that, the offenses took over, and they haven't stopped since. This one may be one of those ones where it's a matter of who has the football last, who wins the football game. Topher Roach kicks it away. And this one goes into the end zone. Touchback will come out to the 20. But right now, we go down and check in with Craig Way. Craig.
Kevin, right after the Fighting Farmers scored that touchdown, Aldine Macarthur head coach Bob Alford gathered some of his offensive players around him and said, hey, there's still plenty of time. 7 minutes to go. That's a world in this football game. An awful lot of time remaining. Take your time. Don't panic. And we can still win a state championship. On the other side of the field, Lewisville head coach Ronnie Gage says, now we've got the lead. Now we have to protect it.
Time to play some defense if you are the guys in white. Neither team done a good job stopping the rush. Delbert Garner to the 25, out to the 28, 29-yard line. Counted off at a gain of 9 on first down.
While Macarthur hasn't been quite as successful rushing the football as Lewisville, they've been much more successful in throwing the ball. So I imagine that yardage is still pretty even. There you see Garner picking up 9 yards.
Well, second down and 1 coming up. Delbert Garner has been quietly getting it done. Garner again on the delay. Out to the 35, a gain of 6 yards this time. Another Macarthur first down.
Little misdirection with the counter trap. You'll see the right guard and tackle pull here. Nice block by both of them. And then Garner will take it outside on the misdirection. But a nice gain out to the 36-yard line. Macarthur picks up another first down.
That's Shadrick George and Gary Brock on that side of the line. From the 35-yard line. Odell James ahead for maybe a couple.
A play that was very successful in the first quarter for Odell James, where he fakes it to the fullback, Satish Hodge, and then follows him through the hole.
Bonenberger was waiting for them. Yeah, that was a big defensive play simply because I can't remember the last time anybody's been stopped for only a gain of 1.
A real setback for Macarthur at 2nd and 9.
With 5:20 and counting.
This is a time where you might see some play-action passing.
A 5A Division II championship. Option, Odell James cuts it up. Boy, he is hammered by Shannon Brazil. Little brother got a big hit in there.
He has great range. Moves sideline to sideline extremely well. Watch it here. James will just cut it up when he feels the notion.
Big number 40.
Zach Welton. There's Zach Welton. 187-pound senior linebacker with a big play there on Odell James.
Third down and 6. Odell James. He'll run it, has the first down. The drive will continue for the Generals of Macarthur. Pete Bonenberger again made the stop, but not before a big gain and another General first down.
A square off of two great sophomores, Odell James and Shannon Brazil, and James wins this battle. Brazil with a chance right there, you saw it, to stop him short of the first down. But James picks it up with a nice bit of running.
Remember, no one had rushed for 100 yards against this Fighting Farmer defense. The way Odell James is going right now, he will rush for 200 yards. and only a sophomore. Quick hitter. Raymond Robinson is open, makes the catch. Blaine Herring makes the tackle. Second time today that that little dump pass has worked big time.
I was a few plays too early in predicting that we'd see this play action pass. But here it is. He fakes it to the fullback and just dumps it down to Raymond Robinson. It's been open all day long. It's only been broken up once. Now Robinson will be over 100 yards in reception.
Both offenses marching up and down the field. Odell James with blockers in front. For the 15-yard line. Zach Welton saved the touchdown.
A new look for Macarthur. They sent Garner in motion all the way to the sideline and sprint Odell James out to that side. You're going to see a great block by Garner as Odell James catches the corner. He reverses out. Now watch the block from Garner coming on the left side of your screen right there. Nice block that springs Odell James for another 10 yards. And this offensive machine of the Macarthur General.
They will try to dig in here on first down and 10 from the 15-yard line. Odell James on the misdirection. James at the 10, knocked out of bounds at the 9-yard line by Dwight Hunter.
Well, during the Lewisville timeout, Macarthur came to the sideline as well. They said that play worked so well to the right side. Let's come back and repeat it to the left side. It's an identical play. You'll see the reverse out by James, and then he'll come down the line. It's a run all the way. Lewisville trying to get containment, but James outruns it.
Well, I tell you what, Shadrick George, number 57, is really getting it done because, remember, Shadrick George is not only playing right offensive guard right now for Macarthur, but he is also playing at nose tackle for Macarthur.
Well, and Anthony Williams going both ways. He's now at left tackle.
Delbert Garner. Touchdown, Macarthur!
We mentioned Shadrick George and we mentioned Anthony Williams. And which way do you think they will go? They're going to run behind their horses. The left side of the offensive line. Nothing fancy about this play. It's a pitch. It's just a sweep. Good blocking and great running for Garner. Great balance. And he would not be denied. Look at it from another angle. Good camera work here. Lead block by George, by Satish Hodge. And a balancing act. A balancing act by Garner to get it into the end zone. Now you look at it from above. Nice cut back there. Blaine Herring not able to make the tackle. And it's a touchdown for Macarthur. And now there's a decision to be made. Do you send Raymond Robinson in to tie the ball game with 3:13 left? Or do you try a two-point conversion and possibly fall short?
This is
and
a tough
trail
call.
By 1 point. Yes, it's tough.
I think you go ahead.
I think I know what's going to happen. Just looking at what the team is doing now, they're going to go for two. Lewisville also huddled on their sideline. I don't think you'd want to go for the tie here.
No.
Although,
and not
there's
the
three
ball.
Minutes left. There could be another 20 minutes worth, 20 points worth of scoring left in this ball game. The way these teams are running up and down the field. And it looks like they may be changing their mind. They're going to continue to meet with the coaching staff, the Macarthur Generals. Lewisville has gone out to defend against the two-point conversion.
And both times, 3:13 to play. Lewisville leads 36-35. And Macarthur going for a two-point conversion and the lead.
Full house backfield. Watch the sweep.
Odell James, it's good.
Zeb Cornist with a valiant effort to stop James short of the goal line. Got a hand on his ankle, but it wasn't enough.
Top of the show. Two great quarterbacks here in this state championship game.
Robinson kicks it away. This one will be a touchback. Lewisville will have to go 80 yards with 3 minutes 13 seconds to play. And you see the timeouts remaining. Ron Ronnie Gage talking it over with Chad Nelson. Nelson with two touchdown runs this afternoon. But in the second half, it's been Dwayne Brazil who has gotten it done for the Fighting Farmers. And he'll have to do it again, the big fullback. So first down and 10. Nelson. How did he ever get out to the 30-yard line? Nelson should have been hit for a loss of two.
It looked like he was stopped dead in the backfield. Somehow he squirmed his way out of that initial tackle. Well, take a look. Let's find out how it happened. He's hit right there and just ducks under the tackle and has the sense to continue on down the field, and only that jersey kept him from going further.
A gain of 10 on first down. Brazil out near the 40-yard line. You can count it off at a gain of 9. Anthony Williams finally made the tackle.
Well, the way this game is going, what Lewisville wants to do is not only go down and score, they want to make sure there's no time left on the clock. Just give the ball to Dwayne Brazil right up the middle. He'll do the rest. He picks up 9. We're down to 2.5 minutes left here in the ball game. Lewisville driving to try to catch up in this ball game.
The Generals of Aldine Macarthur lead the Lewisville Fighting Farmers 37-36. Nelson in all kinds of trouble. He'll lose a couple.
Oh, a big play that time by Charlie Foster.
Came up from a strong safety spot.
Nelson unable to break loose from this one. He reverses his field. He breaks one tackle there, but Charlie Foster with a sure tackle gets him around both legs and down he goes.
Third down and a long one.
50% conversion rate on third down. They're 5 of 10 is Lewisville.
None bigger than this one. Boy, he didn't make it. No, he didn't.
Well, we're in four down territory.
Reggie Crawford.
I guarantee you that Lewisville will be going for it here on fourth and less than one.
And you take your final...
He'll read the defense and then he'll react accordingly.
The play of the game. Fourth down and one. Lewisville with 94 seconds left. On the keeper, he's got the first down. Chad Nelson fights out to the 44. Gutsy call, and a face mask penalty is going to tack on 5 more.
Oh, wow, that could be a big penalty. Move Lewisville closer. What a great fake this was. I was following everybody up the middle, and Chad Nelson rolled out and kept the football and was able to pick up the first down. It's a 5-yard face mask. Watch this. What great faking by all three. Nelson hiding the ball and gets outside and is able to pick up plenty for the first down. Tack on 5 for the face mask, which you saw.
Let's go down and check in with Craig Way. Craig,
Kevin, you see behind me Topher Roach warming up for a possible game-winning field goal try if the Farmers can get in the field goal range. This guy has a gun. He does have a good leg, but the Farmers have to get there first.
They got a good start. They're out to midfield, but only a minute 15 to work with. Chad Nelson trying to get around the corner, gets out of bounds, escorted out by Armin Love. You can see the emotions running high.
Well, the clock a big factor now in this ball game. With no timeouts remaining in a minute 10, it limits what you can do. You've got to either pick up the first down or get out of bounds, or you're not going to be able to set up the offensive scheme and run very many plays. So limited offense now for Lewisville. And they haven't been very successful in throwing the football, which is what they really need to do in this situation.
From the 47-yard line. Right up the middle, Brazil. And Brazil to the 40-yard line. And again, with no timeouts.
He picks up enough for the first down, which will stop the clock at a minute and 4. Just power running right up the middle.
They will
reverse and then hand it off to him. Tackle there by Armin Love, but not before a first down.
Right up the middle again.
Get down. Yep. Clock is running. They need to set it up quickly.
Down to 45 seconds remaining.
And a course, Macarthur not in any hurry to get on their side of the ball. They better get set because Lewisville's going to run the football. Nope, they're going to spike the ball, stop the clock, bring up a 3rd and 8.
With 33 seconds remaining, right now we'd like to take time out to acknowledge a few people for their support in preparing for today's telecast. Thank you.
In case you're wondering, from where they are now, Lewisville would attempt a 56-yard field goal if they were to try.
No timeouts left for Lewisville. Chad Nelson will throw it. Has a man open, complete.
If they can get that, they've got to stop the clock now. 26 seconds, well, the first down will stop the clock, but they've got to move down there, and they have no timeouts. That a 28-yard completion. Is that his? That's his second completion of the day, I believe, and the other one for a touchdown.
And now Macarthur takes
a
timeout.
Very interesting.
What a play. A 28-yard strike. Chad Nelson to LaDarren McClain.
LaDarren McClain just on the post route, play action. They never dreamed that Nelson would put the ball in the air. Perfect pass. LaDarren McClain. There's the play action. Everybody thinking run. Look how close the secondary is to the line of scrimmage. Man-to-man coverage back there in the secondary. McClain comes up with a big catch. Chad Nelson with a great throw. And Lewisville now is at the 10-yard line.
Worst case scenario here is a 27-yard attempt to win the ball game for a field goal because they have the ball set at the 10-yard line.
Well, now the question is, do you go ahead and kick the field goal with 26 seconds left?
I think with
because
this,
if you run a play, you run the risk of letting the clock run out. Probably you can get two plays in. Very interesting.
Plus the ball is directly between the hashes right now.
That's exactly right.
There would be no angle with a field goal.
But you know, I think that Lewisville probably has some concern that if there's any time left on the clock, that Macarthur may be able to come down and score.
Well, I said it earlier that the team to have the ball last may win the ball game. We'll see if I'm right. Only 26 seconds remaining. Hand off Brazil. Touchdown, Lewisville!
We have had a barn burner here. Why would you kick the field goal when you can give it to Brazil? He'll take it 10 yards for the touchdown. And that's exactly what happened. And Lewisville's fans are going crazy, folks. Towels waving in the air. Great emotion on both sidelines. Elation on the Lewisville sideline.
And the point after is good. Unbelievable. Lewisville with 7 points in the first quarter, 14 in the second, 7 in the third, 15 in the fourth. On the other side of that, Macarthur didn't score in the first. They had 14 in the second, 8 in the third, 15 in the fourth. What a ball game this has been. Take a look at it from 10 yards out.
This is a touchdown to go ahead. Right up the middle for Brazil, and he slipped there, but he was not going to be denied. Leaped over the goal line, jumped up and did a little dance. And you think this is going to be a happy coach? Let's see what he thinks about it. I think he's a little bit happy. You know, I hate to say this, but this game's not over. There's 21 seconds left, and the way this thing is gone,
not exactly
anything can happen.
Ronnie Gage is not exactly your stoic type. He enjoys the moment.
I don't blame him.
I don't either.
I'm excited myself.
43-37. What an unbelievable football game. As Lewisville scores with 21 seconds remaining.
How prophetic you were when you said whoever has the ball last may win the game. Wow.
Well, Macarthur is going to get another shot.
We'll see a squib kick here, I'm quite sure.
Topher Roach will kick it. Comes back to Garner. Check it, it's Patterson. Patterson to the 40-yard line with 12 seconds left.
And how important now is your kicking game?
Huge.
Man, oh man. The ball bounced right up to Garner. You'd like to see a squib kick, but the ball bounced right up to Garner. I mean, right up to Patterson. Watch this bounce. Big hop there. And Patterson right up the middle. 46 yards he rambled. A couple of missed tackles. Boy, and give a lot of credit to Zeb.
That's a big guy.
Zeb Cornish. He ran him down from behind. That was one-two. Got 12 seconds left. No timeouts remaining. Trailing by six.
Marcus Elizondo, the backup quarterback, checks in at a wide receiver position. And they'll throw it to him. It's fumbled, picked up. Gary Brock.
What a big play.
Clock is moving. They have no way of stopping it. And that's it.
Wow, what a game.
The Lewisville Fighting Farmers are the 1993 5A Division II champions in a thriller, 43-37. Let's go down and check in with Craig Way.
All right, Kevin, we're here with the head coach of the state champion Lewisville Fighting Farmers, Ronnie Gage. Incredible game.
It's a great, what a great ending to a great season. I love these guys.
Talk about the last drive, the final drive. Who is the one you convert and then come down with the winning points when you have to have?
That's called experience and confidence. I'm telling you, Chad Nelson, Dwayne Brazil, those guys are the best going. And they don't quit. They leave it all out here on the field, and I love them to death.
What did you say to them before that timeout when you had to go for it on fourth and one?
We had to get the first down. That's the game's over. We don't get it. Let's get it.
Did this team ever feel like it was out?
No, I don't think so. They're down, but not out. Never out.
Let's see if we can get the presentation of the state championship trophy right here. And let's go ahead and present it right now. Charles Brighthop of the UIL to present the state championship trophy to Ronnie Gage.
Coach Gage, I know you played at Lewisville for Coach Neil Wilson. You coached for him. You played for him. I know it's a tremendous moment for you. I'd like to congratulate you on behalf of all the UIL schools. 1993 Division II 5A state champions, Lewisville Farmers.
Thank you very much. We'll keep it with pride, I promise you, baby. Right there.
See the trophy there? Ronnie Gage, the happiest man around. The Lewisville Farmers are the 5A Division II state champions. Up to Kevin and Dave.
Well said. And well-deserved in a 43-37 thriller. Congratulations to Ronnie Gage and his bunch in his third season at Lewisville. Brings home the greatest trophy of all, a 5A Division II championship. 43-37, the final, and a thriller from the Astrodome. We're going to take a timeout, exchanging pleasantries after the ball game. 43-37, the final. Kevin Eschenfelder and Dave Elmendorf, along with Craig Way, back at the Astrodome in Houston, Texas. And what more can you say about this one that the scoreboard doesn't already say?
I think Ronnie Gage put it best. He said it was experience that prevailed. Chad Nelson, the senior quarterback, Dwayne Brazil, the senior running back, and don't count Macarthur out. They've got some young talent, and I bet you they will be back.
And that is Neil Wilson. He is hugging down there. Neil Wilson, the athletic director at Lewisville High School, and of course, Ronnie Gage took over after Neil Wilson retired, so a fitting end to this ball game. And this was about as good as it gets.
I'm exhausted, are you? I feel like I played the entire game.
I'm telling you, it was the big one. Dwayne Brazil goes in from 10 yards out with 21 seconds to play, and that was the capper for the Lewisville Fighting Farmers as they win it by a score of 43-37. My friend Dave Elmendorf, I enjoyed working with you. Have a happy holiday. I know you'll be spending some time in Dallas at that Cotton Bowl.
Oh, and I can't wait to see how the Aggies do against Notre Dame.
Well, the coordinating producer and director of Home Sports Entertainment is Mike Anastasio. Today's game has been produced by Murphy Brown and directed by Hill Thornell. The technical director, Mark Alsmeyer. The engineer in charge, George McDaniel. And remote facilities have been provided by Sportscom. once again, congratulations to the Fighting Farmers of Lewisville as they win the Texas 5A Division II Championship by a score of 43-37. So for Dave Elmendorf, Craig Way, and all of us at HSC, I'm Kevin Eschenfelder saying so long from the Astrodome in Houston, Texas. This has been another exclusive presentation of Home Sports Entertainment.
Saturday in the high school ranks, in all five state champions crowned, and how about them Fighting Farmers from Lewisville? Class 5A Division II title game at the Astrodome against Aldine Macarthur. Lewisville quarterback Chad Nelson's second long touchdown run in the first half. This one 55 yards. Farmers build a 28-14 lead early third quarter. Aldine Macarthur a running quarterback as well. It's super sophomore Odell James, 40 yards. He had 190 yards rushing. Lewisville falls behind 29-28. That was a Mac attack. The finish would give you a heart attack. It's Aldine Macarthur taking a 37-36 lead over Ronnie Gage's Lewisville team with 3 minutes to play in the game. Farmers fight back though on the final drive. One fourth down conversion, then this pass to LaDarren McClain sets Lewisville up at the 10-yard line. No timeouts left, and with 22 seconds left in the game, Dwayne Brazil from 10 yards out wins a state championship for Lewisville. 43-37, and a emotional come-from-behind win for the Fighting Farmers.
1993 Division II 5A State Champions, Lewisville Farmers.
Thank you very much. We'll keep it with pride, I promise you, baby. Right there. What a great ending to a great season. I love these guys.
This is the best way to go out. To me, it's the only way to go out. This is the longest game I've been playing, too, but it was a good game. This is the best game I've ever played, the best game I've ever been in.
The most dramatic football game I've ever seen. Lewisville 43-37 winners, the Fighting Farmers' first state championship. Meanwhile, down in Waco tonight, the Dragons of South Lake Carroll looking for their second straight Class 3A state title against those Cuero Gobblers. And surprise, surprise, Aldine Macarthur in Houston, Delbert Garner for Macarthur. The Farmers trailed 37-36 final seconds. But Chad Nelson will hit Darren McClain with the clock down to 26 seconds by the time McClain is down. And from there, it's Dwayne Brazil for the score. That is the winner. 43-37, Lewisville wins the 5A crown.
This is the biggest game I've ever played in my life. I mean, as a senior, this is the best way to go out. To me, it's the only way to go out.
You think it was ever going to end?
The season?
No, the game.
Stephenville Yellow Jackets trying to bring more.
And we did not forget.
Yes, ma'am! Yes, ma'am! Right here, buddy! Right
here, buddy! Off the best game going. The playoff system in Texas is a great time for the kids who play, those who watch, and everybody else in town. It's even better when you win, like they did in Lewisville, Stephenville, and South Lake Carroll.
We started with 64, we're down to two. There's two of us left. And both of us think that we deserve to be state champions. It's all going to be decided Saturday afternoon on the football field. Nothing else matters.
It's a great feeling to know that we're going down as part of history. It's a great feeling.
Never get tired of the state championship. That's what every schoolboy dreams about.
I've been close so many times in my life, and I've never really been number one, so we're finally, you know, as a team, we're number one. I couldn't be prouder of everybody involved.
Person in the world with a coaching staff and the kids that we've got.
is better than the first one. You know, we felt like all season long that we could, you know, get to this point. We had a lot of positions to fill, you know, with all the players that we lost from last year. And it just feels twice as good as last year.
Football team and what a great ending to a great season.
Good stuff, but I think I've seen just about enough of that ice water being dumped on a coach. It's the Cowboys and Redskins next Sunday night, not the matchup it used to be, but
last night, defending champion South Lake Carroll with lineman Joel Holmes recovering the fumble for a touchdown, winning over Cuero 14-6. Carroll completes another unbeaten season. 47 straight games without a loss now, and South Lake Carroll will probably move up to Class 4A, having won three 3A state titles the past 6 years.
It's awesome. It's the greatest feeling I ever had. It's what I dreamed of since I was a little kid, and now we've done it.
You know, this is a great thing for the kids. They deserved it. They worked real hard. And coaching staff, you know, right now I'm the luckiest person in the world with the coaching staff and the kids that we've got.
In South Lake, they're celebrating, and the same goes for Stephenville. 4A final in Austin Saturday. Stephenville quarterback Brandon Stewart, two touchdown runs, and the Yellow Jackets beat Lamarck 26-13. A perfect season. It's Stephenville's first state championship ever. And then there's the Fighting Farmers of Lewisville. They need to add a couple of words to that landmark water tower in Lewisville. Now it should read, home of the state champion Fighting Farmers. What a week it was, and Terry Briggs has the story.
Know what's going on?
2 weeks ago, Lewisville head coach Ronnie Gage dared his team to dream.
Everybody that ever plays a sport lives for a dream. We're one step away from living that dream. All right, but it's a tough step because these guys can play, and you know what kind of tradition they have down there. They know how to play, but so does Lewisville.
They went out and proved it to the defending state champions from Temple. Yes, the 1993 Fighting Farmers dared to dream.
Yeah, we're going to the show, guys. We're going to play the big game.
Hey, I lied to you. This wasn't the biggest game of your lives. We're playing for the state championship. Yeah! Great job. I love you guys. I love you, coaches. I love LHS.
By Tuesday, they were back to where it all began, the practice field, where they sweated through two-a-days back in August, where they repeated drill after drill through an undefeated regular season, and where they got stronger as the shadows got longer deep in December. This week was the reason for all that work.
This is what you dream about. It's great.
On Friday, it was time for their work to be rewarded, and an overflow crowd of farmer faithful listened as a coach spoke straight from the heart.
These young men sitting out here are what coaches dream about. of young men I've ever been associated with.
And then everyone got all shook up about Lewisville's dream team. The Astrodome was now the final destination on the road to a championship, and it was obvious that this team had captured the imagination of their entire hometown.
I mean, if that don't pump you up, nothing else will. You just have no choice but to go down there and play hard.
For a little while, it looked like this would be a Saturday afternoon stroll for the Farmers, but Aldine Macarthur soon got their offense up to speed, and this turned into one of the greatest championship games in Texas high school history. After the Farmers took a 28-14 third quarter lead, Mac counterattacked, led by their sensational sophomore quarterback, Odell James. His two touchdown runs helped the Generals take the lead. Then after the teams traded fourth quarter touchdowns, it was James going for the two-point conversion and the lead again. It's good. With 3:13 to go, the Farmers faced a first down at their own 20 and their biggest challenge of the season.
Every week, I don't see how we can get any better, but we seem to dig a little bit deeper, and that's why I love these kids so much.
On a fourth and one, they dug in again. On the keeper, he's got the first down. Then they faced a third and seven. No timeouts left for Lewisville. Chad Nelson will throw it. Has a man open, complete. And finally, from the Macarthur 10. Hand off Brazil. Touchdown, Lewisville.
This is the best game I've ever played, the best game I've ever been in.
What a great ending to a great season. I love these guys.
Coach, the city of Lewisville feels the same way. This is Terry Briggs for Sports Extra.
Best football game I've ever seen. The high school season complete. Now it's over.